Akilah Trinae, Cameron David, DJ Reed, Miss Ro-Ro, Dontrell Detroit, Key 77. This is U Nation Radio.
Monday night, love session. Check us out, Generation. Slow jams, conversation. Late night, stimulation. Call in, love session. Love session,
Monday night. Good evening, good evening, good evening, everyone.
DJ No Sage.
DJ No Sage in the building.
Oh, you heard?
Well, happy new year to everyone. It is 2015. Whoop, whoop. I'm your girl, Akilah Trinae. You are tuned in to Monday Night Love Sessions on U Nation Radio. Thank you, Chris, a little bit, slightly. Just to let you guys know, we have a good show in store for you today. We're talking about music industry and how it is glorifying strippers. We have a building full today, so we're going to get to know our hosts, and the hosts are going to host and do what they do and let you know whatever information they need to let you know. So you're in for a good show. So kicking it to my left. To Mr. SB. Oh, shout out to Cam, who's not here, who's sick today. But I'm sure you may be watching, so we miss you. Happy New Year.
Bro. I'm not Cam. I mean,
I said I'm going to kick it to my SB.
Yo, hello. SB in the building. Shout out to all my people. Happy New Year to everybody. I'd like to give a shout out real quick. To all our sponsors, shout out to Pitbull. All right, shout out to Artistic Web. Shout out to Black Line Entertainment. And without further ado, I'm gonna kick it to my left, to Miss Ro-Ro.
Happy New Year.
Turn up.
How you guys doing today? Happy New Year. To my left is my baby, DJ Reed.
What's up, everybody?
Oh, no. Happy yo today? No.
It's a new year, so I have to retire it.
No, not really.
Yeah, because nobody was feeling it. True. So
you could have made us feel it. You get what I'm saying?
No, that was
you could have turned it up.
That wasn't working either.
Or No Sage could turn it up with the background music.
Okay.
My bad.
I was like, something feel a little dry. Feel a little dry.
But
go ahead.
But it is a new year, and to start off the new year, if you haven't done so, follow us on our social media. If it's never, yeah,
it's there.
Facebook, U Nation Radio, Twitter at U Nation _ Radio, Instagram U Nation Radio, Google Plus U Nation Radio, and YouTube U Nation Radio TV. And now I'm about to kick it over to Miss Keys 77.
What up?
What up?
It is I. Well, hello. Happy New Year. Good evening, everyone. Well, we got DJ No Sage. Hey, DJ No Sage in the building.
Yeah, yeah. What's going on?
Hey, what's today?
You already know what it is. Yo to the noobs, it's Founders Day for Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity Incorporated. Yours truly, DJ No Sage, live here in the mix with RMC, holding it down. Let's get it. Monday Night Love Sessions, let's go.
What is it? We going to the Zen Lounge after this.
Hey.
In Studio City.
Okay. I'm hopping in somebody's car. saying.
Let them know you can hit us up tonight. Call in. Check us out. 323-965-1600. Call in. Come into the conversation. Let us know what you feel about this music industry. Jacob.
And these strippers. And we also got over there.
Oh.
Over there, over yonder, DJ LA.
DJ LA.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Just celebrated a birthday.
Yes. All the
turned
way.
Up, for real.
All the way turned up.
Hey, Happy New Year's to everyone.
Now he's trying to act all mellow.
Listening. Yeah, I'm on my level. I'm on my
Oh, you got mellow. The sexy voice,
though. I can't hear myself in the earphone, so.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'm on
you
my
You might need to turn too. Yourself up or something.
Yeah, it's all good.
I yeah, it's not even plugged in. Maybe
that's
well,
why.
You need a little thing to plug it in. No.
Well, I will. Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
I will say this. I want to give a shout out. If you see the shirt I have on, Felipe Ifani, one of my good friends from Oakland. So over the break, I had to go to Oakland. Y'all know how I do for the holidays. And it's a shirt, and it's called Destiny. And I just want to share this with y'all real quick. Basically, with every shirt that he comes out with, there's like a kind of explanation that goes with it. So each day we are blessed with a breath of life. It is another day to step into our destiny and work towards our visions as well as dreams. Once you take that step, you're orchestrating in activation, which is your greatness that resides in your soul. Therefore, step out on faith and take that first step into destiny. So shout out to Felipe Ifani. I believe you have. Oh, yeah. There's his social media. So check him out. Patronize. Black-owned business. You know, that's kind of where we're trying to move in 2015 to support our own, support our peoples.
Yes.
So, we have to.
Shout out.
Shout out.
Shout out. DJ No Sides.
DJ No Sides.
DJ No Sides.
What you got to say to it?
I was just calling the name.
Okay. Are you gonna play Detroit?
Yeah, I'm gonna play Detroit. Yeah, what? I'm finna play Detroit. DJ No Sides hit us with the 1-2.
DJ No Sides. DJ No Sides.
Where Brooklyn at? 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 Where Brooklyn at?
You wanna sit more? My living room flow, play Nintendo with seasonino. Pick up my phone, say I'm a not home. Sex all night, mad head in the moon. Spin my V, smoke all my weed. Tattoo on, you say it B-I-G. Now check it, you wanna be my mid squeeze, baby. Don't you, you wanna give me what I need, baby. Won't you, picture life as my wife. Just think, full left, make fat X and O licks. Bracelets to match, conversation was all that. Showed you the safe combinations and all that. Guess you can say you's the one I trusted. Who would ever think that you would spread like mustard? Got hot, you sent feds to my spot. Took me to court, tried to take all I got. Another to get blocked, the said I ripped up. Damn, why she wanna stick me for my paper?
You never seen nothing like this. Splash Brothers with the aim. I wish it would, boy. I'm singing, sleeping with your missus. Call me Young Mellow, cause scoring is my dish, boy. I'm CP3 cause I be dishing and handling the rock. Chef cooking
DJ
with
No
the pot, boy. It's all about the, all about the money. It's all about the, all about the money. It's all about the, all about the money. It's all about the, all about the money.
I be in the hood, drop Wrangler. Toilet paper in my post cause I'm 94 from Whitmore in the kitchen. In the kitchen. Cooking birds, saying thanks for giving. Thanks for giving. On the Schwarzenegger, on from the whippin', from the whippin'. On the Schwarzenegger, on from the whippin', from the whippin'. One reply to you, sneak this, sneak this. Suck it, when you see me, know I'm grippin'.
You never seen nothing like this. Splash Brothers with the aim.
DJ No Sides.
I wish it would, boy. I'm singing, sleeping with your missus. Call me Young Mellow, cause scoring is my dish, boy. I'm CP3 cause I be dishing and handling the rock. Chef cooking with the pot, boy. It's all about the, all about the money. It's all about the, all about the money. It's all about the, all about the money.
the money. It's all about the money.
I go 0 to 100 real quick. Real quick, whole squad on that real shit. 0 to 100 real quick. Real quick, real off quick. Was being on some chill shit. We go 0 to 100 real quick. Maybe on that rap to pay the bill. And I don't feel that shit, not even a little bit. Oh Lord, know yourself, know your worth. My actions being louder than my words. How you sold, I been still sold down to earth. Won't do it, we could do it on the turf. Oh Lord, I'm the rookie and the vet. Shout out to the position that I ain't holding down the set. All up in my phone looking at pictures from the other night. She gon' be upset if she keep scrolling to the left, dog. She gon' see, since she don't wanna see. She ain't ready for it. If I ain't the greatest, then I'm headed for it. Yeah, that mean I'm way up. Yeah, the six ain't friendly, but that's where I lay up. The motherfucking layup. I been Steph Curry with the shot. Been cooking with the sauce. Chef Curry with the pot, boy. 360 with the wrist, boy. Hey, who the fuck is this, boy? OVO, man, we really with the shits, boy. Yeah, really with the shits. I should probably sign a hit, boy, cause I got all the hits, boy. All that Drake, you gotta chill, shit. I be on my little mouse drill, shit. Boy, all that rap to pay your bills, shit. Yeah, I'm on some rappers, pay my bills. All up on TV, I thought it made me richer. Wasn't paying me enough, I needed something quicker. So now I'm all in Nico basement, putting working on the phones. Either that or drive the money mark to make the pickups. Man, it's 2008, I'm trying to paint the picture. Comeback season in the works, and now I'm thinking bigger. I got 40 in the studio, every night, late night. Gotta watch it, don't wanna make them sicker. That's my nigga, oh Lord. Got a whole lot to show for it. I mean, we could really get it, we could go for it. I'm just here for the bucks and the billy. Don't make me kill one of the ghosts for it. I run this shit like go for us. Run for us, run for us, go for us. Run for us, run for us, go for us. Run for us, run for us, go for us. Yeah, I mean, y'all already wrote for us. Damn, go us one more quote for us. Oh Lord, who else sounded like this? They ain't made me what I am, they just found me like this. I was ready. Oh, shit, I've been ready since my dad used to tell me he would come into the house to get me. He ain't show up. Valuable lesson, man, I had to grow up. That's why I never ask for help. I do it for you, and do it for myself. I go 0 to 100 real quick. Real quick. Whole squad on that real shit. 0 to 100 real quick. Real quick.
Yeah?
Ice in my rolling, no wonder I play it cool. Ain't no I in team, but I got
my eyes on you. I watch it bounce when she walks, she lick her lips when she talk. I throw her in that Bentley coupe with the top up like Mardi Gras. All that cake, come get you some feeling. Like a soap, I can watch all my children. Hit it so long that you might lose feeling with a lady.
All right. So if you're just tuning in with us today, Monday Night Love Sessions, I'm Akilah Trene. We are talking about the music industry and how the music industry, specifically like R&B, but we are going to talk a little bit about rap and hip hop, how it seems like now they're glorifying strippers. During the break, you heard DJ No Sige on the ones and twos, so shout out to him for always coming out, supporting, showing love, and being here. We appreciate him. So when you know, as we're talking, he's going to hook us up with our background music. So if you like what you hear, obviously go support him. Go download his mixtapes, so forth, and so on. But he'll give you more information about that towards the end of the show. So how did we come to this topic? Well, first of all, I was listening to the radio and hearing a lot of Usher and, like, Neo you saw in the video. And I was really just thinking, like, man, like, what's going on with the whole stripper thing? I'm clueless. I don't understand. And so we have this article that we're going to just read a little bit from just to kind of get our conversation going. Is everybody good? Everybody straight? During the break, C. Ballin joined us.
I don't know if you have
the camera over there. So you can
How we doing?
Say
Happy New Year. Happy
hey
New Year
to the people. Tiana, if you want to share a little bit.
C. Ballin is a producer, right? Tell us about yourself. Wait, you call me out. Yeah, I know. Well, C. Ballin, tell us a little bit about yourself and, you know, what do you do in the industry?
Well, I'm a music producer. I'm in the music industry and, yeah. You know, I'm a producer from L.A., work with a lot of cats from out here, like YG, 40, and a bunch of cats like that. Been doing it for a minute.
Hanging out. He's a friend, and he came to join our conversation. He has a lot of input, so I figured that he would be good to come on the show.
Well, we're happy to have you.
Well, thank you for having me
here. And yeah, just join in, you know, where you want to get
absolutely,
in.
Absolutely, absolutely. I'm hanging out.
So what's the biz.com featured this article. It's the two face of hip hop. And so when I was reading over it, I was like, this is the perfect way to start our conversation. So I want you guys to listen in. And then, you know, if it's something that popped out to you, then we can kind of start there with our conversation. So it says, oh, you dance like how, like ballet and ish. Oh, wait, I get it. I'm with it. Drake line and fall for your type. Is it just me, or is every song about the glorification of the stripper? No longer do young girls have lawyers, doctors, politicians, or artists to look up to. They can finally take the fast route to a short life and become a stripper. Why does a 12-year-old know strippers' names and how they look? And as if they're old enough to get into a strip club. Why is the new norm going to strip clubs to party? Why are rappers making love songs dedicated to strippers? Why does every young girl have fake, thick eyelashes? Wait, I'm sorry, I digress. That's just a personal pet peeve of mine. Back on the subject, is every song going to be about strippers and hoes? If my self-esteem was any lower, I would have to change professions just to keep up with the demand. Just imagine what the goals of these young girls with no family structure or foundation have become. They can't turn on the radio without discovering that bands will surely make her dance, or that a seemingly wealthy man loves them strippers. And that one must become a bad bitch in order to be valued in society. So now they need makeup, weave, booty implants, tight clothes, and Photoshop. Maybe they too can become the next Malia, Drea, or Kimbella. School no longer gets you out of the projects. A poll does, metal or anatomical.
Ridiculous.
The formula: heavy bass line and stripper chorus equals success. Has anyone other than myself paid attention to the verse in I Love Them Strippers by 2 Chainz? Not once does he talk about strippers, the verse just says it. The closest we get to a stripper is Nicki talking about taking Black China from Tyga, which is another issue. He tell the son that lap dance, well anyway, that part's not important. Let me see, there's another part I wanted you guys to hear. So, Follow Me songs by Drake, Lil Wayne, The Weeknd, etc. Young MCs have them doing more than just throwing money around. There's relationships, emotional yearning, and caring, whilst older cats such as Juicy J, Jeezy, and 2 Chainz have stuck with traditional stripper behavior. Pay, play, and go on your way. Prime example, bands will make her dance. Juicy J describes her, gets dome, throws money, and if you listen closely, the ad lib is yeah ho after every line. It goes on to basically just talk about how what's happening now is men are actually becoming weaker, is what it says, and in the sense of wanting to control certain types of women. So honestly, that they're glorifying these strippers and going after the stripper type because they feel as though that they can have more control over a woman who has low self-esteem, or, and I'm not making the assumption that all women who strip have low self-esteem, so don't even take it there. But that's just basically the argument that they're making here, and that men need to become a little bit stronger in the sense of being able to find women that are just as strong as they are, or just as strong-willed as they are, and not wanting to take advantage of another woman because of her career and or self-esteem.
How do you feel about that, SB?
You got it. You're the woman.
And why? What do you
ladies
mean
first.
I'm the woman? He said ladies first. I don't think that's right. I mean, music will be music, but it's up to the woman to understand who she really, you know, who she really is. A stripper, I mean, they making money. I can't knock they career, they money maker. If they feel that they stripping is what's gonna make their money, that's them. But I don't feel they should be talked about and called sluts and stuff, because some people do it for the money, not for the attention.
Can I understand something, right? With me being in this whole, whatever you want to call it, I've been there, done that, right?
Mm-hmm. Done what?
Okay, this the scene you're talking about.
Either
if it's music,
no, I'm just
party
wanting
and
you to be specific,
strippers and entertainment. Let's go entertainment.
Entertainment.
Right? That's their thing. That's how they get paid. You know, that's what they do.
Right.
You know? Now, understand, with anything, you got to own it. Now, a lot of these strippers, they own it. You know? And they understand, like, this is what comes along with.
Mm-hmm.
You get what I'm saying? Just like a lot of church people are called hypocrites.
Yeah.
You hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But that's the truth. A lot of these strippers are really sucking privacy in the back of the club. They're doing that to get that extra $100-$150 because they got a bill to pay. But see, nobody knows that. So of course they're gonna sit here and act like, oh, why would they call us that? They know what they're doing. You know, this is real life. You know, I've seen it and I'm good. I don't need to do all that, but I know what goes on behind those curtains. You know what I'm saying? So I mean, a lot of times when they're calling them that, I mean, some of the things are factual. Not
so you think it's okay?
Right. Hell no,
I'm just
it's not
say,
right.
You think it's okay for like?
I'm not saying it's right, but you know, you call a spade, and a joker is a joker.
No.
Because if I promise you right now, if a dude get out of line, you gonna call him a B-A-N. You know what that is? Should I say it?
I know what it is.
Should I say it, audience? I don't know. But that's how you gonna feel about it. You know what I'm saying? But just because these niggas got dollars and they got stacks, you know, and they treating them how they're acting.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? Like, oh, now they're looked down upon because that's what they're doing. But they not tripping. The women not tripping. Because it don't matter. Whatever they got going on, they're going
to
do whatever they
need to do. So you have a daughter. You have a daughter.
And I'll be damned.
And you have a daughter.
Damned.
So you
damned.
Allow your daughter.
Fuck no.
To listen to
oh, no. Hey.
So if she want to become a stripper, you're not.
You're okay
gonna...
with that?
Okay, here's my thing. My daughter, I didn't even want her to be a cheerleader.
Why not?
You know what? You want to know the truth?
Hold up. Cheerleading. I was in drill team.
Okay, whatever. I'm going to tell you the truth because I'm a jock. I've been there, done that as well. And I'm going to tell you the truth. You name one group of women in the whole school that the goths want to hump on, the Mexicans want to hump on,
the goths,
the athletes, the musicians,
I know
all
who the goths
everybody,
are.
the face of the school usually is the cheerleaders. They have cheerleaders there when you get people coming in to become, you know, new students to come to the school. You got football season. They're out there doing tumbles and flips in skirts and panties. I'm sorry. What are we appealing to? And I'll be damned if I'm sitting in this audience.
So
and
it's
a nigga, and a nigga say, ooh, that chocolate wood on the end got a fat ass. Bop! Baby, hey, let's go. Time to go.
Well, you know, me a nigga. You
time
know,
to go.
But you're looking at it from a bad... I'm like, you're looking at it from that point
but
of view.
But I'm looking at it from reality, sweetheart. If
I mean,
that's real.
I mean, that's... You know what? Not my sister. Yeah, my sister won't allow my niece to become a cheerleader.
And I agree.
Cheerleader, because she believed that most of the girls are nowadays are more fast, you know, playing on makeup.
Yeah, because they're watching these videos, you know? They're watching reality TV, and what do they see? They see women.
No. I have to interject. It ain't even watching the videos the coaches.
Well, I was a cheerleader. I was a drill team.
The coaches.
It's the coaches.
It's the coach.
No, I understand the culture.
She's right now is in, she's doing the cheer competition. She's in that realm of cheering, you feel me? But I won't allow her to cheer for a football team because that is the ratchetest shit that I have ever seen in my life. They all want to dance to Red Nose.
And they all want to
toot it up and pop and all that. You get what I'm saying?
So when she go to high school, you're not going to allow her to be a cheerleader?
Hell,
she's going to want to.
You know what what's most important in that sense is I think,
you can't
because the article
her.
Is talking about some of these women feeling possibly having lower self-esteem or feeling as though that their body is the only thing that can get them the money that they need to make. Or knowing that, okay, I have a nice body or I paid for this body, so I'm going to go get paid for it. As a father, I'm assuming, to a daughter, what needs to happen or needs to be instilled in her, because she may choose to go that route anyway is to instill in her that she's a beautiful young girl and that she doesn't necessarily need the attention of a man in order to, you know what I'm saying, have her self-esteem to go up and all of that.
I agree. But to again, like, it's the way you raise your child as well. And although that is significant, that shit don't matter either. Why? Because I know people that were raised correctly and they chose to steer away. You know what I mean? But that's just what they wanted to do. But hell, this parenting did not come with a goddamn instruction manual.
You're right.
What I'm saying? And I spoil my daughter as much as possible. But when she knows when she got to take care of school, she got to take care of business first. So she needs to know how it feels to be taken care of or what she needs to look for in a man. You know what I mean? So I need to be the best example that I can to her. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Although I ain't perfect, because I can get ratchet as hell.
So one of the things I wonder...
Just to be honest.
C-Ballin, and you might be able to chime in on this, because we are talking about the music industry, and I know that there are a lot of rappers, and we kind of started it on rappers, but I kind of want to also transition into the R&B, you know, as we played Neo. R&B is now starting to go down that same route where I'm like, okay, well, where's the divide? Where was the love-making music or the honoring women and men and all that stuff through R&B, but... as a producer, I know that some of these rappers have daughters and have children. If you ask some of them, they're like, no, I wouldn't allow my, you know, daughter to listen to this music because it's just music. Or it's just, this is what I do. This is my living here. But I don't really live that lifestyle. They may not really be out in the strip club all the time, but that's kind of what's portrayed. Like, what is your input or take on that aspect?
So that's the thing. She came over. We had a little function. It was like the even amount of guys, even amount of girls. So we had that kind of came up. So it got loud. You know, are you making this type of music? And do you condone this? And you know, she asked me. She was like, because I don't have any kids yet. Mm-hmm. But she asked me like, would you let your child? You know, because I got a hook I did like with me, Ty Dolla $ign and Glasses called That Good. And we talking about that good dick. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Music right now, whether you like it or not, is real vulgar. It's real, like, ratchet. And it's like that because that's what the audience wants. It's not that...
That's what we've evolved to.
Yeah, we ain't in the studio just like, you know what? Let's just make... No, we want to make something that's going to go in the club. We're gonna make something the DJ gonna play. You know what I mean? So she posed that question to me. It's real simple. Would I let my children listen to any of that? No.
Shit.
He went to the record. I know producers and people that's like, you know, older than me that's been in the game that have families, and they families live far as hell away in Palmdale in some big house. Mm-hmm. They go to private school. They can't watch rated PG-13.
Right.
Let alone listen to, you know, any of that type of music. But it's just a supply and demand thing, I think. Like, you know, like, I'll give you a good example. One of my good friends, I ain't gonna say his name, not put him on blast, but he just did a dope documentary on hip hop music, on how it started, you know, with the graffiti and the tagging and the battling and the DJing and the art form and how we got so far away from it. He was just like, man, you know, we just had the BET Awards or Soul Train Awards, and we got Stevie Wonder there and this and that. But we got Bobby Smurder closing it out with Hot Nigga. And it's just, where are we at with it right now?
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll tell you this. Wow. Me and my girl, we went to the show, and it was you know, they was kind of bashing the music today, which a lot of people do from the old you know, older generations. But when we went to the club afterward, we went to a little after party, when Hot Nigga came on, guess what he did? He got up and started doing that dance.
Who, Stevie Wonder?
No, my guy that made that funny too.
I know.
Stevie Wonder, how you learn?
No, first, I was about to say, the first thing I would have said, like, nigga, how you know this dance? How did you learn it? Exactly. Did somebody put your hands up and was like, but we're not going to talk about that. Go ahead.
But this, I'm just saying the same thing he was kind of hating on.
Right.
So what I was telling her, it's a feel-good thing. It's not necessarily, do we want you to go do these things? No, it's how you feeling right then in the club. When you're in the club, you turned up, you're going to dance. You know what I mean? It's the same thing with violence. We're not necessarily wanting to get violent, but we might say all that shit while we're in the club, drunk in that mode, in that moment. And, you know, I'll say the same thing for, you know, the whole stripper situation. I think that Usher record is crazy, like, as far as it's sending a message. It's like negative, crazy in a negative way. You know, like, I don't mind, you know what I mean?
Yeah, like, exactly.
Be independent. Like, he making stripping in the same league of being a lawyer or something. You independent woman, you know, go out there. And that's a bad message. I think that's crazy. But you know what? You gotta realize something too, what people don't realize in the consumer part of it. It's actually songwriters that write these songs. Usher didn't write that record. Rock City wrote that record.
But he sang on it. He condoned it. He
co-signed it. And him being who he is right now.
He got to stay relevant, too.
You know, he got to stay relevant. My guy right on the point. You got to stay. Mm-hmm. He got to feel like some of these dudes got families, and they don't do nothing. They don't go to the club. But it's just like the label, like, yo, Usher, you need one. You know, get with these young producers, and this is what's hot right now. Go sing that. Mm-hmm. And then they go, psh, blow it up. You know what I mean? And
I think the biggest thing that what you said is, you said feel good music, because I know personally, like, I love a good beat. You know what I'm saying? And I love to dance. So if a good beat comes on, then I start listening to the lyrics. And I'm like, oh, Lord, this is terrible. Okay, if you could, like, turn down the lyrics and turn up the beat, then I'm good. But at the same time, I know that I'm not going to go and try and do the stuff on the record. Whereas there are some people who believe that what's going on in the record is reality, and it's not. So it's almost like I can go and listen to the music and dance to it, but I'm not going to also be like, oh, you know what? I think I might be able to do this, you know?
Right.
Just because I know the difference, and I know, you know, the gifts and talents that I have, you know what I'm saying, to be able to do that. And I think that's the most important part, especially for young
daughters
to let them know, like, you can go out and you can have fun, and you may, you know, turn up and do all of those different things, but you have to do it in moderation, and you also have to be careful for yourself as a young woman, that some of these men are not looking at you like, oh yeah, I want to wife you, I want to take care of you, they're looking at you like, no, you have breasts, you have booty, you know how to move it, and I might want to take you home for a night, but I'm not really trying to be with you like that.
Now it's a party.
So true. I tell that to my nieces, because they're 13 and 14 years old.
Okay.
And I let them know to, you know, be careful, you know, because there's a lot of young boys that they like, oh my gosh, those young boys are so good.
Parenting, good parenting is at an all-time need right now. You got to be able to get out there and tell your kids what's what. You can't just let them sit back and let the radio do the parenting. You know what I mean? So it's like, it's some responsibility. But I'll just say one more thing to add to that. When I first started, like kind of getting around in the industry, I was working for Snoop for a long time. I was an engineer. And he said something to somebody else that really stuck with me for a long time. This was like 6 years ago. He was like, you know, I want to make positive records. I want to make, you know, uplifting records. But every time I go to the label with it, they like, nah.
Mm-hmm.
And that's somebody that, mm-hmm. for me to hear somebody of power like that that's been doing it for so long say that, it just let me know right then and there. It's like, that's not what's in demand. You can go buy gospel right now and bang it, but they're not going to play it in the club. It's not going to happen. I mean, it's just reality. This mm-hmm. the reality of it. That world is that world, and that's what they want to hear, you know?
That's who buying records.
Yeah.
That's who buying records. That's what they playing, you know?
And
for me, it's
music.
A feeling, you know? If it feel good, like, when we go to the studio, we want to do something that feel good. Like, you know, where the writers go with that, you know, it could go a lot of places. But I'll tell you one thing. If it wasn't in demand, it wouldn't be playing right now.
On the real.
If the twerk wasn't in demand, we would stop making records with saying twerk and pop it and drop it and clap it and pop the bottle.
Glee.
And we're going to talk about that whole one for sure series. After the break.
Glee did a whole series on twerking.
That's how you know.
Are you serious?
You know? And just talk about...
Did they do a whistle while you twerk?
Nah, it was just kind of like, they tried to ban twerking. It was like, twerking is a part of life, you know? It was weird. You got to watch it on... I was watching it on Hulu.
Twerking is a part of life.
But you know what? Wait, I'm going to say this.
I was talking to you.
Really quick. Because you were talking about the whole twerking thing. And if you go back, like... in our history, and you go to other parts of the world and other countries, like they dance, they whine, they move their bodies, and it's like it's within them. But when it becomes now an objectification thing, like now I'm trying to capitalize
that movement,
make money off of
a body movement,
a woman's body, where it now becomes an object, then that becomes a problem because there's nothing wrong with the movement of the body. You get what I'm saying?
But a woman's body is a blessing, though. Jesus.
And it is. But you know what? It has now become something that is it's filthy. You get what I'm saying? Like, it's made filthy, and that is just another, I guess, X or, you know, what I'm trying to say. It's like another negative against women. You get what I mean? Where something that God blessed women with is now being used as a tool against them, and it becomes a distraction. Because a lot of this music, the twerking, the dropping it and popping mollies and drugs and alcohol and all that stuff becomes a distraction from the things that are really going on.
Now it's a tool.
And if we can keep black people distracted, you get what I'm saying?
They will always
then other stuff is going on. Because where are people
but
going
But you say
to
it's
it?
A tool against them, right?
Mm-hmm.
But this is the same thing that they're blessed with that is getting them bills paid as well. You feel me? That's putting them through school, literally.
Right.
That's getting their kid, that's paying their tuition to their private school.
I can understand that, but that doesn't mean that's the
only
way it has to
go. Don't get me
wrong. Because there's a lot of psychological stuff that goes with that. So it's like, I'm going to sacrifice my
integrity.
Mental, my spiritual being to go and make this money because I have to do it. Just like people who prostitute. I have to go make this money. They're not really, I mean, out there just because it's like, ooh, I like having sex and this is a good career.
You ever dated
a
drug dealer?
Otherwise, they can be a porn star.
Have you ever dated a drug dealer? No?
I don't know. He could have been doing drugs.
My point. I'm not saying doing them, but have you ever dated a drug dealer?
Dealing drugs, that's what I meant to say.
On the low, like,
on
but that's how he make his money. Like, it's just on his hustle on the low. He not going to tell you. But that's what he's doing. It ain't right.
That's fine. But what I'm saying is, if he's not going to tell me with that example, if he's not going to tell me, that means it's something that he's not proud of. That means that's something he's doing to make ends meet. So what I'm saying is, there's still a psychological piece that goes with that. Like, I'm going to have to do X, Y, and Z to make this money.
Now, let me ask this question.
Don't ask the question yet, because we need to go.
I'm not going
to
ask the question. I'm not.
We got to go
hold
back.
On to the question.
We got to go back and let DJ know, Saj.
Turn up then.
Amen, amen. I was waiting for that.
I got a good point, too, to bring up, too, when we come back.
Yeet.
So we're going to no side, and then we'll be back. So we can collect our thoughts.
Yeet.
There we go.
My sister, somebody gonna be my victim. Got me a turn up shot.
DJ No Size,
know how to party. VIP turned up with the models. Drink free so we turn up the bottle. Rubbing on her body, twerking. Licking out her tongue like she thirsty. Hands in the air when her song on. Love dancing in the mirror with her thong on. Know what she want and she gon' get it. I know what I want and I'm gon' hit it. Look in her eyes saying, come get it. Cry to the side, I gotta come with it. Real cute face, nice teeth.
Uncut.
Explicit. Open, make a tip. You might get a cash roll if you show that air tone. You might get a cash roll if you show that air tone. We be really throwing hundreds cause we really getting money. We be really throwing hundreds cause we really getting money. See a fool, everybody throwing teeth on that boots. I'm sloppy, I'm pissing, I'm Rose and Chris. I'm drinking, I'm driving, I'm celebrating, living. I'm smoking, I'm sipping, hands down, I'm pimping. I can still see some haters in the corners of my eyes. I ain't worried about nothing, man, this motherfucker lies.
To Bugatti, y'all motherfuckers start running from the paparazzi. Got four hoes in the pool of my jacuzzi. Full up, drop top, finna opera, it's a movie. You see the diamonds in my watch, it ain't a G-Shot. Balenciaga on my feet, it's in a Reebok.
I'm in the W.
Never ever been to the double tree. Eating steak and shrimp on a yacht, fuck Applebee's. Gianni Versace, I come to your city, take over like Nazi. I got hoes from the A to the Bay. Round, round in the coupe, going crazy.
Round, round in the A. In the coupe going crazy. I ain't worried about shit, young nigga, I'm rich. It's fuck you pay me. Don't let your hoe come around me, I'ma take your life.
Your chick come close to me. She ain't going home where she supposed to be. I'm getting money like I'm supposed to be. I'm getting money like I'm supposed to be. Oh, all my niggas close to me. And all them other niggas where they supposed to be. Oh, the hoes go for me. And your chicks in the pit like post for me. Oh, that's how I supposed to be. Yeah, that's how I supposed to be. Yeah, that's how I supposed to be. Everything up like a
DJ No Size.
Pull up to the club and it go up. Make your girl fall in love when I show up. It's not my fault, she wanna know me. She told me you was just a hummer. She came down like she knew me.
All right, and we're back. So No Sage is obviously letting you guys know the ratchet music that that is out at this time that bumps, as C Ballin said, in the club. I want to give a quick shout out to 8.9. Thanks for tuning in and listening. Appreciate you. You know, the secret names we got today. But SB had a question for us before we went to the break.
Now, you know what? It probably won't have the same impact, but I'll kind of rephrase it. To this point, I'll say, you were saying like, oh, they're doing things that, you know, they're probably pretty much not
proud of,
right? But if you get down on your luck and you low on funds, but you got bills due and you need to make these ends meet, There's no telling what you will do when you get to that point.
Okay. That doesn't mean you're going to be proud of it.
I'm not saying you will.
But what I'm saying is, even when you get to that point, it's not to say that you don't suffer in some type of way mentally for something you do when you get down. Because, I mean, you could do anything when you get down on your luck or whatever. You make some decisions and you're like, man, I probably shouldn't have done that. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But that doesn't mean that there's still not a part of you that still has to deal with that. Doesn't mean that it just goes away. For somebody, I would assume for somebody who's like, okay, just randomly throwing in Nene, for example, right?
Yeah.
From Housewives of Atlanta.
I was just
like,
thinking
it's
that
not
too.
Necessarily a proud time of her life. She talks about it, but she also dealt with some other things as a woman, just being abused and things of that nature. But at the same time, she's trying to do other things to kind of make her money. But one of the things that she always talks about is she was never the type of person to just be super overly sexualized or nasty. You know what I mean? Like, because I know, like, when Candy bring her stuff around, she'd be like, no, I'm not into that. I'm not going to do that. But they always try and say, well, you used to strip. So why are you getting all tensed up now? And it's like, well, that doesn't mean that I wanted to do X, Y, and Z. It just means that for whatever time it was, she was young, she made those decisions.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So I guess my thing with people who are women and men, because men strip too, but we're not, songs aren't about men stripping. You know what I'm saying?
That's what I'm saying.
I don't think he's going to get there neither. Yeah. Hopefully not.
Thank you, baby.
Hopefully not.
Unless there was a woman who actually did write a song about men stripping. You know?
What?
Anyway.
What you mean, Motivation by Kelly Rowland?
I don't know.
Hey, but it's just, you know what though? Times are totally different though, you know? And this is what I was saying when we were bringing up, you brought up TV. Somebody brought up TV.
Oh, yeah, I said TV.
Modern Family opposed to Family Matters.
You're absolutely right.
You get what I'm saying?
Mm. Uh-huh.
Scandal.
The world's waxing worse and worse.
Scandal opposed to
what?
Small Wonder.
Hi.
You know?
Small Wonder was about a little girl robot. I mean,
it doesn't matter. It was so innocent. Now, Scandal got, what's the guy named that he talks like this and da-da-da-da-da? The white guy, and he's doing a...
Cyrus?
Yeah.
Not Cyrus.
He's putting his privacy in Boy Booty Hole. Like,
oh, yeah, they're showing
come on now.
Yeah,
they showing it.
Well, look,
I've never seen men kiss in the mouth so often. And I'd be so uncomfortable.
How to get away with murder?
But that's where we at. This is where we're at.
But we don't have to stay there.
It's not that we have to stay there, but this is where we're at. And his point, this is where we feel good, and that's where everybody's evolving to.
We don't feel good when men is kissing men in the mouth.
Listen, I'm not okay with that.
Okay, I'm just saying.
But
that's
the thing is, that's where this generation is going. It's a lot more people that's openly saying, like, yeah, I kiss boys in the mouth, and I'm like, but you're like, and you're like, I don't get it, but I'm not going to judge you for what you do because, whatever. Everybody does.
I just want to add on to what he said, though. It was real, real relevant where he was talking about making ends meet. Now, I know women that really, they strip, but they make a good, really decent amount of money.
On the real. I've seen it. I had to help count.
They're paying bills. They live in a nice apartment. And they going to school. And they're working toward a degree. Like, I really know women that do that. And they're not out here, you know, actually hoeing. And, you know, they might have a boyfriend or whatever the case may be. So just to play the devil's advocate, it is some women out here just using that as a stepping stone to build on their, you know, ultimate goal.
And I understand that. Now, once they get to their goal, are they going to continue to strip?
Hopefully not. I mean, if you're trying to get a degree and, you know, start a career,
so what I'm saying is, in that, it's like, I'm doing
criminal
this.
Studies. Why would you be stripping for criminal?
Right.
That's to take care of
the bills.
But
why not? If you're making good money, why not continue doing it? You get what I'm saying?
No, because they don't want to be there. They don't want to. The girls that I'm talking about, they don't want to be there forever. They don't want to be that old. You know.
You were not about to be 30 out here popping your vagina.
Yeah, you are going to be 30.
Come on.
30 is the new 20.
You know what? Yes, I lied because I do know one.
Right.
Yeah.
I do know
sure
one. I just seen her in a video, too.
It's not a good thing.
Though. I ain't going to say her name because it's the homegirl.
You get what I mean? And actually, the angle that I want to take is not even more so for the women. I know that women do it, but when we get there in a second, I kind of want to take a totally different approach to the whole situation. So anyway, I was driving back from Oakland. I'm in the car, and I was in a rental, so I was listening to XM Radio, the Heat. I believe it was The Heat.
Mm-hmm.
And they played this song, Can't Trust No Thoughts or something like that. And I thought it was by French Montana, but it's by somebody named Wash. Y'all probably know more than I do. Featuring French Montana. And the gist of the song is, you can't trust no thoughts. He said these women come up in the club, basically looking for the dudes with all the money, who's popping bottles and VIP, looking for handbags and Gucci bags and all that stuff. He said you can't trust them because all they want is the money. But I know that they're looking for the money, so I'm about to throw the money at them, and I'm still going to take them home. And all of a sudden, I was just thinking in my mind, like, well, you can trust a thought because you know exactly
what you're going to get.
What they're about. You know what I'm saying? You know what the situation
is.
Daddy.
And
they're going to do exactly
home?
What you want them to do.
I know.
And you're okay with that.
He wants to smash their vagina. That's why.
Oh,
duh. Yeah, right. Saying, but you're going to talk about them. But yet at the same time.
I would never
time,
talk about anybody
that's not,
that
that's
wants
a hypocrite
to bust
right
a nut.
There. I mean, that's just.
Why would I do
now,
that? That's
now,
stupid.
I'm talking
See,
about.
Just to jump in right there.
Go ahead.
What y'all got to realize is not all these songs make sense.
They don't make sense. And I'm the type of look at the lyrics.
In the studio,
like,
they be in the studio, they don't be sitting there like, you know what, guys, let's really think about how we're going to attack this, the grammar. And you, niggas be high and drunk, like turned up, like, you know what, thoughts. And this is what we're going to say.
Real, hey.
This is what this rhymes with that.
Perfect
Cat
example.
Rhymes with hat and it sounds
right.
good. You
perfect
know?
Example. Joe yeah. Moses had a song called Go Bitch.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you
yeah.
remember that. And
it's a big
the funniest right thing, I would go boom, boom, boom. I'll mix that in. Ticka, ticka, boom. And they'd be like, Go Bitch. And you know who's singing it?
Oh, yeah. I was about to go there with you. I was about to go right there with you.
All the women. The niggas are singing it, too. But the women like, Go Bitch. That's my shit, girl.
They got manipulated.
It's not. It's a good song, and they feel it.
It's a feeling. Just like the thought songs, all the songs you're talking about, the women sing it more than the dudes doing the club.
Like, it's crazy. It's just, like, you going to let me hit or no?
Right.
And you know what? I'm so glad y'all said that, because this is where I really want to take it. So, we showed the video Neo, She Knows, right? Mm-hmm. And in the lyrics, he's like, you know from the moment she turned around, she know how to back it up and drop it down. She know what all the fellows looking at, because they know soon as her song come on, it's a rap. And she loves the attention that she gets when she moves, yeah, showing out with her homegirls, hypnotizing all the dudes. Oh, and she knows, she knows, she knows, she knows. Y'all know the rest
mm-hmm.
of the song.
Mm-hmm.
So I was thinking about this, and I was like doing research, and I was looking into different things. And it was funny because I came across Proverbs in the Bible. And I know it's just a crazy little transition, and you don't have to make no face, but I'm about to tell you this because this is deep, right? So Solomon, y'all know anything about the Bible?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay,
I'm
so Solomon was a man who... was all about wisdom,
mm-hmm.
right? And I think Key was telling me about in a conversation.
That's so
you
funny because
about,
I brought Solomon
you,
up.
You were talking about men in the Bible and
right.
having multiple
right.
wives, having
uh-huh.
multiple women and all of
right.
that. But the crazy thing is, and specifically in Proverbs 7, Solomon is warning men
mm-hmm.
about women seducing them and taking them for the things that they have. Basically, not just so much like the physical things like your money and all of that, but women who know exactly what they're doing with their bodies and are manipulating men, and men are then giving in to the seduction, basically, of this woman. And he's warning them because basically he's saying that men are going to go out and look for women.
Mm-hmm.
They know what they're doing. That's the
mm-hmm.
plan. They will even go out and seek a woman that they know is not good for them. Because
mm-hmm.
naturally, men are attracted, you know, to women.
Right.
And vice versa. So he's saying, like, you have to be careful because this woman, and he tells a story, so y'all can go back and read it in your personal time, but he tells a story like, this woman basically seduced this man, told him to come back to my house. Don't worry, my husband's not home. He's not gonna be here for a while. So she's already setting up the situation, and he's like, oh, okay,
mm-hmm.
your husband's not home, so that means the coast is clear. Like, I can go ahead and come in this situation. She also says, well, guess what? I'm going to make love to you, and it's going to be safe. Nothing's going to happen to you. You won't get any diseases. I'm not going to get pregnant. And I'm translating it to, like, modern times because it's like the woman saying, I'm on the pill. I, you know what I'm saying, you're not going to have a baby. Women who then turn these things around and trap men because they know, again, go back to the song, you can't trust a thought. Women know, and I'm talking about not all women, but there are some women who have evil intentions out to get men. That is their goal to do. When they strip a man, like when a man falls in love for the first time and a woman just did him wrong, she had no intention of doing you right. It was like, I know what he has and I know what I have and I know what I can do to get everything through to him. And now he's stripped of like everything, and now he don't even want to treat a woman or love a woman in the same way because he's like, I can't trust this woman anymore because she got over on me or she did whatever. But I just thought it was crazy how it was laid out, the whole situation, way back in Proverbs, of what's going on now. Now women know, I know I have this body. I know I can go pay money to get implants. I know I can pay money to get booty injections, and I know that men are gonna like it. And now I'm gonna use that to manipulate the man to get everything out of him that I want and have no issue or problem with it. And they go home and lay in bed at night and they're cool with it. And the man, some men, those who are, I would say, like upstanding, who actually care, who, you know what I mean, want better for themselves and life in the future, are like stuck now, like, dang, what? I just, you know what I'm saying? I just got tucked in for everything that I had over this woman, over some booty, over some, because the breast, woman knows how anything, to seduce. You know? She knows what words to say.
I'ma
this
you,
type of woman.
I'm going to tell you a secret.
Okay, because men do the same thing.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to tell you a secret. And it's funny, Lil Wayne said this. He said, when I come to my senses. If that ain't the most honest.
Ooh, that's
quote,
deep.
That's
man.
Deep right here, that just register what you just said.
Yes.
Like, nigga, we'll be ready to run through a brick wall when that shit's backed up. It's like, man, what? You want a what?
Anything.
In the what?
See?
By the what? Shit.
They go hit anything.
You know what I'm saying? And then you be like, oh, shit. Woo. You're like, you know what?
See,
I shouldn't even have did that.
To go on, when she brought the situation up, she brought up the whole cheating thing.
Yes, I did.
She brought up that classic question. Well, why do men cheat? And, you know, can a man, my boyfriend don't love me if he cheat on me and all this and that. And I was like, of course he do. Because cheating ain't got nothing to do with love. And women don't want to hear that. And every man in the room, him way over there, agree with me because...
We're
thinking about one thing only, like that man said. We see something like that, you know, she was like, well, what if your woman is having a lot of sex with you and satisfying you? That don't mean nothing. That don't mean if we don't see the next, you know, pretty thing walking by, we ain't going, you know.
Meaning
at the
like
end of the day, this is the rawness of it.
That's what I'm assuming. Like, they're getting bored.
We are like dogs. I'm sorry. We're like animals. We got that nature. It's sin nature. That's what sin is.
Mm-hmm.
It's not that it's something wrong because that's, you know, how we were born. Now, we have to fight it. We're supposed to fight it. We're not supposed to...
Temptation,
hit
yeah.
...hit everything right. we see. Mm-hmm. But some right. people do. Some
You're
niggas
right.
do.
But that's where wisdom comes in. You know what
but,
I mean?
But
making
just
those to,
just
choices.
Why I brought up Solomon is because she said, well, what if we did that?
Yeah.
Hell, I ain't going to do that.
We can do
yeah,
that.
No,
no because nah. in, I said, you know why? We're different. People get away from that now. A man is different from a woman.
Absolutely.
We totally clearly different.
Clearly.
You know, now it's a whole lot of 50-50 and I want to be like you and I could be able to do this. I should be able to have sex with 10 guys. No, it's not like that. That's when I brought up in the Bible. Solomon, I don't know how many wives Solomon had. I mean, I'm not saying let's go get married to a bunch of women, but you ain't never found in the Bible a woman married to 10 men. You know what I'm saying?
Well, no, because it was looked down
upon. Or you don't
upon,
see a lion. When you see, I told her about it. You see a lion pride. You see one male and 10, you know, females around. It's only going to be one male. If another male come around there, it's going to be a problem. Just that's how nature is built.
I about to say that's just how it's built. You know? Yeah,
you know?
I like I said, I don't necessarily agree. I feel like a woman... Can do whatever she wants.
He was saying
I thought that was the end of the statement. Like, what?
I know, me too.
You feel like a woman.
I feel like a woman could do whatever.
Oh, no.
Hey, you are lethal with that voiceover, son. Hey, but no, for real, I feel like a woman should be able to do what she wants because we have the right to do what we want, you know? And the only reason why it's formulated like it was is because historically, that's just how it was set up.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a woman wasn't even able to look at another man. All they were supposed to do was sit at
There's
home.
There's some religions right now. You,
right.
Yeah.
You, and take care of the kids. And that's all they were supposed to do. And if you did, it was okay. It was It was what was it called? It was popular for a nigga to beat the shit out of his girlfriend.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
You know,
over in you know Iraq and they
do that.
They'll stone you to death.
Right, but see, that's what I'm saying. Now a woman has the right to vote. She has her own job. She don't really need a man. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So
she's
doing her own thing.
Get another baby. I feel like she can have a baby without a man.
I feel like she can do what she wants, but it's right. not popular for her to do that, you know?
Mm.
And but like you said, it's the nature of how everything was brought up and how everything is the foundation of this life that we're living. You right. know, it's not popular for a woman to just be like, you know what, yeah, I feel like doing this and this and this and this, and then I did it with him and him, but I don't really care.
But there's a reason for that. You get what I'm saying?
Whatever the reason is, it can be that. That's fine. I'm not disagreeing with that at all, you know? But like I said, if a man goes and have 6 or 7 girlfriends
so
and he's manipulating them to get what he needs out of them, it's like, oh, this nigga's the man. But if a woman do that, she's like, oh, my God, girl, you a hoe.
Mm-hmm.
Is she really?
I know.
You thought.
You know? Hey, man.
There's males out there who are hoes. I mean, it doesn't matter if you're a male or a female who is out like that. If you are doing that, manipulating, you know, men or women, if you're a woman manipulating men, if you're a man manipulating women, I believe it doesn't matter. You're still a hoe. It doesn't matter.
No. I don't believe that either. A hoe is when you do things.
It doesn't matter if you're. I know. And if you're a male, what if you're a male?
Sexual favors.
What if you're a male prostitute? Because there are male prostitutes.
Compensation.
Right.
Like, you know what? I need to get home. You know what? Come here. Let me lick your pussy so I can get to the house. Mm. My bad. Let me give you some oral copulation so you can take me to the house.
Yeah,
you
know, that word is misused all the time.
You know, like that's what a hoe is.
A hoe is a hoe. A hoe is not, you know, a promiscuous person.
Yeah, like it doesn't matter what you do because you feel it. If you're in the moment and you feel it, like why do you have to feel guilty for what you feel like, you know?
Right.
Especially if you're single, like this is what you feel like doing. Why are you not doing it? Because somebody's gonna judge you for some rules that who made up?
Nobody made
right. Wow. Who the hell is making these rules?
The world.
There's no rules.
But my girl, or hopefully not your husband, is not finna be, you know.
That's when there's rules.
That's when there's rules.
Okay, but in your scenario, then why should that matter? If based on what you said, if a woman feels like she wants to go have sex with another man over here, why? Is that a problem if that's what she feels like doing?
Because at some point, you become responsible for somebody else's feelings.
So why is that not the same thing
if you're single, okay, my bad.
You're not responsible for nobody else's feelings?
Let me say it again. If you're single, you're responsible for your own feelings. If he's doing his thing and you understand you guys have a mutual agreement, that's fine. Whatever you guys come up with. You know, where we all lack as a community... As a people, we lack in communication, you know? So if I like you and I feel for you, but you know what I'm saying? We're not at the point in life to where we can be existing as one. You know, you do your thing, I do my thing, but make sure our paths don't cross to where I feel disrespected and I feel like you're doing me wrong. Then, okay, we got that established, and that's what it is, you know? But if you're my girl and I'm your man and I need to be responsible for your feelings and I don't need to be out here making you look stupid in the public, you know what I'm saying, and I don't need to do nothing to hurt you, then now I'm held accountable for my actions. Mm. I can't be out here,
accountable when you're in a relationship? That's the part that
why
I'm
not?
Talking about.
Why not?
I said, why are you only held accountable when you're in a relationship and not when you're outside of one?
Who do I have to answer to if I'm single?
If you're in a relationship, if you're in a committed relationship, if you're talking about husband, wife, because that's what most people think of when they talk about like, oh, you're cheating this and stepping outside of the marriage or breaking the vows and all the other stuff, right? Because you made a commitment under God to say, hey, we're going to be together, right?
Mm-hmm. True.
Outside of that, if you're dating, we're not married. You get what I'm saying? I still don't have any obligation to you.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Because
I don't know about that one though.
If we've established,
what do you mean?
Hold on.
If she wanted to go out and do whatever she wanted to do,
if we have established that we're dating and we're all exclusive.
Like, there you go, exclusive. There you go. That's the word
we are exclusive. You feel me? And we have agreed that I won't be over here touching on Jan, Keisha, and LaShante. I agree to this.
Right.
This is what I'm telling you. Like, I'm giving you my word. Like, no, I'm good. I only want to deal with you.
Absolutely.
And we're going to build from here and see where this goes. If we've agreed to that and we're exclusive, then that's what it is. I have to marry.
You might as well give her a ring or say, you know what?
No, but she doesn't deserve
it. Well, I'm not even talking about turning dating into marriage. That's not my point.
What?
My point is...
The fuck?
You don't have to, like,
listen.
I'm just saying, I'm talking about promise ring or something.
My point is more so about
exclusive.
Single, dating, married. I don't feel as though people should be out sexing people up and down all over the place. Because at the same time, you still have that body to take care of.
Yeah.
Right. And every time you enter into a woman or a woman allows a man to enter into her, it's a spirit, but it's also an exchange that you're having. And at the same time, it's the mental breakdown, it's the spiritual breakdown, but also, you know, more than that, there's your bodies is rubbing and touching and
doing stuff.
You get what I'm saying?
Right.
And so there are still diseases, there are all that stuff. But outside of that, I'm just saying that if people just take better care of themselves mentally, spiritually, physically, then they'd be able to make better decisions in the unions that they enter, whether it's dating, whether it's marriage or whatever, because people don't like to admit to it, but just like I said, when those strippers are out there, there's a mental thing going on. Yes, they put on a facade and say, this is okay for me because I have to justify it while I'm making this money. I'm going to school. I'm getting what I need to get done. So I justify it. But at the same time, they still have to go back home to themselves as a woman and live as a woman and live up to everything that you've done. So you might try and the same way you put on like, oh, I'm doing X, Y, and Z and I don't want to worry about people judging me. It's the same way people put on and be like, I'm going to do this because I want people to accept me in this way. But either way, it's judgment on both sides.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So it's like, either way, you still have to make those choices. But I'm just saying, overall, that people still have to deal with those decisions that they make. And there's a mental, there's a spiritual, and there's a physical breakdown that happens.
And to jump in right there, that's why a lot of strippers, like I know a few... They do a lot of drugs. They usually do drugs. They get high before they while
get
they
drunk
work.
Before they
it's
do
a, it's
it.
It's something that to get in that zone where they could, you know, be comfortable. It's 100 dudes in here looking up my vagina. You know what I mean? Like, they gotta get there. They gotta always kind of be in that state, because if they wasn't, then they might realize what's going on.
Right.
And be like, damn, I'm really.
Really stripping.
Really out here busting it open.
Aren't
strippers like afraid of what's going to happen in their near future? I mean, like, you know, they say they want to go to school, they're doing this and that just to, what if they do get that degree and they want to just become a doctor and then all of a sudden somebody found out that they were an actual stripper and don't want to hire them because of what happened in their past and all that stuff?
That is what happens.
You know what else is promoting this too?
Yeah.
Reality TV right now.
On the real.
A lot of strippers they make it to these shows and, you know, they see them, you see them elevate, kind of graduate and open businesses like Black China, and they marry, you know, rappers like that. It's kind of like a path, like, oh, I'm going to do this for a little bit, then I'm going to be like Black China, and I'm Drake is going to talk about me. You know, it's mental. It's the same thing. Like, you know, it's kind of false
advertisement.
Yeah. False hope.
But to that point,
mm-hmm.
I'm almost for sure that nobody goes into the strip game like, you know what? I can't wait to be a granny in this strip club. Mm-hmm. You know?
Right.
It's all for now.
Right.
You know, because everything,
they're young, they're
because gravity
young.
Is going to take hold to you sooner or later.
Exactly.
You get what I'm saying? Now, regardless of however you think it's going to happen, that shit's going to happen.
Yeah.
So
not
let me
let
get it
in.
Let me
no
make these thousands. Let me make these thousands of why this God-given body I got is going to make me this money, and I'm going to go to school and I'm going to get what I need to get so I can get where I need to get. You know? Some of them got kids for real, and they don't really want their kids to know what they did to pay for them noodles that they was eating, them noodles and hot dogs they was eating the other night.
They don't know nothing else. They don't got no other
means. You know something?
What they going to do?
We're going to get to that, Ms. Roro. We're going to get to that, but we have to go to a break. So hit us up, DJ No Size.
Right. She said, woo.
We got that bubble replacement.
feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling my, feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling my, feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling my, feeling myself. I'm feeling myself.
DJ No Size.
I'm with some hood girls looking back at it, and a good girl in my tax bracket. Got a black card and less sex habit. These Chanel bags is a bad habit. I do balls, damn Mavericks. My Maybach, black Maddie. Bitch never left, but I'm back at it, and I'm feeling myself, Jack Rabbit. Feeling myself, back off, cause I'm feeling myself, Jack off. If you think about me when he wax off, wax on? National anthem, hats off. Then I curve that nigga like a bad horse. Let me get a number two with some Mac sauce, or on a run tour with my mask off.
I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling my, feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling my, feeling my, feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling my, feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling my.
Change the game with that digital drop. Know where you was when that digital pop. I stopped the world. Male or female, it make no difference. I stopped the world. World stop, stop, stop.
Carry
stop.
On.
Kitsy on fleek. Pretty on fleek. Pretty gang, always keep them niggas on geek. Biting, biting through Texas. Feed him for his breakfast. Every time I whip it, I be talking so reckless. He said, damn, Nikki is tight. I said, yeah, nigga, you right. He said, damn, babe, you so little, but you be really taking that pipe. I said, yes, daddy, I do. Give me brain like NYU. I said, teach me, nigga, teach me. All this learning here is by you.
I'm whipping that work. He digging that work. I got it. 36 of that real. Pinky full of that bills, baby. Come get you some of that bounce.
I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling my, feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling my, feeling my, feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling my, feeling myself. I'm feeling myself. I'm feeling my.
Cooking up the bass, looking like a kilo. He just wanna taste, digging up my ego. Bitches ain't got punchlines or flow. Have both and an empire also. Getting gifts from Santa Claus at the North Pole. Today I'm icy, but I'm praying for some more snow. Let that hoe ho, let that hoe know.
He in love with that cork.
I'm in love with the cork. I'm in love with the cork. I'm in love with the coco. I'm in love with the coco. Baking soda. I'm in love with the coco. I got it for the Lolo. I'm in love with the coco. Baking soda. I got baking soda. Baking soda. I got baking soda. Whip it through the glass, nigga. I'm blowing money fast, nigga. I'm in love with the coco. I'm in love with the coco. I got it for the Lolo. I'm in love with the coco. I'm in love with the coco. I'm in love with the coco. I got it for the Lolo.
Turn up.
I'm in love with the coco. Hit my plug, that's my cholo. Cause he got it for the Lolo. If you snitching, I go loco. Hit you with that 38. Niggas thinking that I'm solo. 50 deep, they like, oh no.
No, please, no.
Heard the fans taking photos. I know nothing, fuck the popo. Baking soda, I got baking soda. Baking soda, I got baking soda. Whip it through the glass, nigga.
DJ No Size.
I'm blowing money fast, nigga. I'm in love with the coco. I'm in love with the coco. I got it for the Lolo.
And we are back, Monday Night Love Sessions. We're talking about the music industry and how it's glorifying strippers. We've had a very good conversation up until this point. But I want to hear from Nosaj as a DJ. Well, we know SB's a DJ. But I want to hear from him as a DJ.
Yeah.
And as a person who plays the turn up, feel good. What was the other thing you said, C-Baller?
Ratchet.
Ratchet.
That's the word of this millennium.
Or
this
funny thing is, do you know the definition of a ratchet? Not really, but you can point her out when you see one.
Just like a
I want to know.
No, that was a thought.
No, a thought, a ratchet, everything. Anything.
All that, yeah, all together. A ratchet act. It's a hoe.
It's a noun.
It's in an urban dictionary.
Shout out Joe Moses. Go Bitch was the first time I heard that word. He might have coined that phrase.
Oh, yeah, hell yeah.
Ratchet?
No, actually, I heard Ratchet with Lil Boosie earlier on.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but Ratchet, I mean, like, if like coined it, like, yeah, I say Joe Moses, but like Lil Boosie, like earlier on.
Where did that come from?
I know.
I didn't think
it was London. That's all, like, that's like if you.
But in the West Coast, yeah, Joe Moses, he coined that. Yeah, absolutely.
London and UK, they said the word ratchet for many, many years before it even came.
I think it came
in London. They just said it in London, Mike. I don't think it said it in London.
I think it was a mix up of wretched. You know that word. I think it was something that
stuff like that. Ghetto.
Ratchet got ghetto, you know? And it went to ratchet.
Got ghetto. Ratchet.
But you want to, I'm going to tell y'all this, though.
And
to
be
honest, and I'm still coming to you, Nosaj. To be honest, in our culture and in this time, when you think of thoughts, when you think, well, not so much thoughts, but I'll just say ratchet. Most of the time, people think black women. And that's the most unfortunate part about it. I talked to my students about it. Because they told me one time, like, yeah, all the ratchets hang out in this area. And I said, okay, this is what I want y'all to do. I gave them an assignment, not specifically for the ratchets, but to go out and, like, with a map and identify where everybody hangs out, the different, like, cliques or groups or whatever. And they told me, like, the ratchets hung out into this one section. I said, well, tell me this. Those ratchets that you guys are talking about, what race are they? And they're like, oh, they're black. And I was like, so what does ratchet mean? You know, the people who are loud and like ghetto and like doing too much, all, you know, got their music playing and all this stuff. And I was thinking, like, well, that's crazy. Whatever the word means, people normally take words and add their own definitions or meanings to it. Mm-hmm. But for them, when they thought of the word ratchet, I'm talking about a school with predominantly Hispanic, they already identified that the ratchets were the black people. Mm. And that, I don't know, I felt some type of way about that, hearing that, because I was like,
that's so racist.
That's where it's going. So whenever we hear ratchet, at the end of the day, you don't think white girl. You don't think an Asian girl. You don't think a Mexican girl.
It's just like the word ghetto. It's
you think,
like,
of a black woman, and that's the unfortunate part.
Well,
we got a caller.
Oh, okay.
We got a caller.
Tell us your name.
Tell us your name, where you from.
Hello, I'm calling from Mars, California.
Hello, Lord. Can you speak
up
again?
Who is
that?
That's Don
Trail. D.O.
Nah.
Happy New Year, Detroit.
Happy New Year, Ms. Roro.
How you doing?
Sorry that I couldn't make it in tonight. Show ran a little long and getting away with a little issue, but it was awesome, and she sent the regards. But I am listening to you on the way home.
Where
you at, nigga?
You guys sound so much better without me.
What?
No.
Well, it is 2015. What you trying to say?
Whatever, bro. What's your issue, man? What you got to say,
what,
man? Turn
us
up.
Tell us something.
Oh, okay. Well, quickly, I didn't really get to hear all the content, really. But what I will say, I was telling you what my premise was. I don't know if you guys got the video. There's a real blurred line caused by women as to why men glorify women in strip club songs. Men, this is the truth. The music industry is the truth. That's what's happening right now, period. You can't deny it, because everybody that's not stripping, it wants to be a stripper, or they're auditioning to be a stripper, or they're exercising somehow to be a stripper. With that being said, stripping is a bottom-line business. It makes little sense to get that much money. So women are figuring out, well, if it's artistically done, everybody's doing it, then I can do it to get this money, and it's the quickest money ever that's legally that quick. On the flip side, it's something that if we don't educate, or people that go in thinking like, okay, I'm going to do this for a means or some type of means. It doesn't have to be a means to go anywhere, but a means to accomplish a goal. Then those are the people that we should worry about. It's not really derogatory, because everybody wants to do it, but it's only derogatory for those that are scared to jump into it, but love it from afar, kind of like Beyonce and her haters.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Hey, when you say stuff like that, I be thinking to myself, you the one the Lord chose on the red. That was
somebody
deep.
Wanna, say hello.
Somebody wants to say hello?
Yeah. I don't know what he's talking about.
Is that Darnell?
What's up, yo?
Yo, but stripping is the female version of hustling.
Yeah,
girls,
yeah.
Girls don't show drugs. Girls don't stand on corners unless they pulling. But it's the female version of hustling.
I agree with that.
It's the easy way.
That's going
to make money. Yeah. So therefore, yes.
It's they trap. It's the trap.
Well, so that's what they call glorified. It. But therefore, it ain't no different. It's just the easy way to get money. It ain't no artistic or nothing like that. It, I don't know what this nigga Detroit talking about.
Oh, but you're saying it's not art?
It's not art. No, it's not art.
It is art.
How much art does it take for you somebody to stand thinks up on it's a art pole over here and dance around and like you do in your mirror when you come out the shower?
Hey, funny thing right, is, bro, in all honesty, it ain't as easy as you think it is.
Wait, no, it's not easy. But here's the difference. Detroit mentioned stripping and then he, but he mentioned exercising and right, audition or whatever. Exactly. Pole dancing doesn't necessarily mean you're stripping.
I have friends of mine who pole.
Pole dancing can be used for exercising purposes. And I, you know what? Because I took a pole dancing class, and I was like, you know what? These strippers be working hard. You know what I'm saying? The ones that be on them poles.
Money for pole dancing.
What'd you say?
Dancing, like my man on the woods, say dancing.
Dancing.
Yeah, but you're getting money for pole dancing.
The volume's so low in here.
You said,
were
you getting money for pole dancing?
No. Absolutely.
No, it was an exercise.
It was actually, you know, it was a workout.
You paid to work out, but you wasn't getting paid to work out.
No, I wasn't.
Okay, then. So, therefore, that's not stripping. You talking about as far as the form of art.
No, that's stripping. What I wasn't talking about. It was art. That was somebody else in here. I was telling you that somebody said in here that they thought it was art. I was referring to what Detroit said about stripping and pole dancing, because I was like, They could be different.
They are different.
You can be a stripper and dance on the pole. You know what I'm saying?
Bottom line, stripping is a hustle. It can be derogatory, or it can be as far as, okay, you get money, whatever. It's a paycheck. So, okay, it can be viewed as that. But men or the world glorifies it because it comes up as sexy, and people love the vision of women. So, therefore, it comes off as sex sales. So yeah, if I'm standing and I'm standing in the mirror and I'm shaking my ass and trying to make it twerk, hey, cool. But the only people that's gonna be stripped, like, you look at male strippers, most of the male strippers have female tendencies.
Oh, he's down talking to you, Don Trail.
Wow, just look at him.
Thank you for calling. Darrell, you gonna talk
Darnell.
Thank you for calling. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Who is that? That's Keith.
Hey, text my line, bro, right now.
I got you.
Yeah.
All right, well, you guys have a good evening, and we're going to get to know Sox, because I want to know, as a DJ, I got to set it up all over again.
All over again. Hit it with
all over again. So as a DJ,
DJ Spiffy Loke.
You're the one playing the music to get people to dance in the club. Does it matter what tracks you're playing? Would you, as a DJ, play something if it was like it was feel good, but it was like positive type of deal? Or is there an art to the using the ratchet in the club and getting the party going?
Well, yeah. I mean, we're in an era where ratchet is in. Just like, you know, every era, you know, there was a jerkin era, there was a hyphy era, there was a crunk era with Lil Jon. So now this is the era of the twerking / ratchet, you know, era. So that's what the people want. So that's what I give them.
Yep.
Wow. Straight up.
The point.
Same thing. For me, as a producer that makes the music, it's the exact same thing. It's what the people want. If I wasn't doing what the people want, I wouldn't be in business.
Exactly.
Hey, because on the real, I would play Tank, Tyrese, a little bit of Frankie Beverly and Maze, and I'd be like turned up by my lonesome.
See, that's the type of party I want.
But that's
play
us.
Old 90s music.
Hey, but that's,
90s
play that too.
But you gotta
too.
Understand.
Oh my God. That's what I want in my heart.
Really, really? I haven't been to a club where I heard Kendrick Lamar's "I." Really, at like a peak hour, at 12 o'clock or 12:30, I really haven't heard that.
You know what you hear at 12 o'clock? I don't fuck with you.
Exactly.
That's what you got to play at. That's the peak hour.
That's the number one song on Rhythmic Radio right now.
That song is terrible.
It's very terrible. But you got to think about it. Everybody can relate to it.
I think about all my exes when I hear that song.
Exactly.
You from yesterday.
What? Nigga, it's my joint right here.
I was just talking.
You know, I'm never the dude to be like, oh, nigga, that's my shit.
Yeah.
But when I hear that.
That one? Yeah.
I remember when she was like, yo, I don't want to talk to you no more. Like, oh, I got a boyfriend. Mm-hmm. Oh, wait, what? You want me to call you? What? Wait, you said you stranded?
Hey, you know
you
what?
You need me to come pick you up?
Hey, guess what?
I'm
going to
add on to that.
I'm going to add on to that.
That's
seductive for a woman that got y'all.
You know what,
bent out of shape.
You know what you can take from what he just said? Why that's so powerful? Because that's a feeling.
Mm-hmm.
You're not saying I don't mess with you. When you feel like that, I don't fuck with you. And then when you feeling like that, that's why he made the song to be real. He didn't make it to be, oh, I don't like you.
Hey, that was out of emotion. The place he came from when he made that was when his ex. That shit was personal.
And got a boyfriend.
right.
Cheated on him.
Mm-hmm.
And he like, wait, you calling me, bitch? I don't fuck with you. The fuck? Don't call my line, because I got no feelings involved. You know what
I'm saying? But it's all feelings involved.
But is it really, or is it not? Because, like, you know what? The fact that I'm telling you that I don't fuck with you, like, yeah, I'm mad, and I was mad, but right now,
I'm still mad.
I'm good, because right now, I get to sit back on the outside of my situation and look at it.
Right.
Because when I was in it, I was blind as fuck. You know what I mean? I couldn't see the things that was going on because I was so involved with you.
Love is blind. Hey.
Yeah. I was loving on you like
that's
damn.
That's why you needed some wisdom.
Yeah, but I need you to F up so I can see what's going on and I can step back and be like, damn, I was doing that. Like, I was really a bitch ass nigga.
Hey.
On the real. Like, you know what I'm saying? You had me turning loose.
You gotta check yourself sometimes.
Like a real
man. A band.
Whatever. Like, you know what I'm saying? So, when someone, like I said, in hindsight is clearly 2020. Mm. You know what I mean? But when you in it, you don't really see it like that because you're like, damn, I really love you. Like, babe, no, we don't need to break up. Mm. And she keeps like, we should break up. And you're like, nah, we don't need to break up. And then y'all break up. And you be like, you know what?
We needed to break up.
This B word was stupid as hell. You know what I'm saying? She was dumb as dishwater.
But yeah, I think that's why the music is vulgar. I think that's why the music is vulgar today, because that's how you feel. Like the kids now is telling you how they feel. They ain't holding no punches. You know what I mean?
Everybody used to want to be in love. You know what I'm saying? Lenny Williams was like, because I love
you. So nobody
want
to be in love anymore?
We want to be in love, but the problem is especially like Keisha Cole.
Mm-hmm.
Keisha Cole, when she was singing about how these niggas did her wrong, everybody was like, yes, bitch, this is my song in a club. Like, you know, like, as soon as she started talking about how much in love she was, it was like,
okay.
I ain't really feeling her that much.
On to the next record.
You get what I'm saying? Because on the real, everybody has in their pocket a stupid nigga. And I can attest to that because I used to be one of them.
Wow. Really?
You know what I mean? But nah, I wasn't that bad. You know what I'm talking about? But everybody got a stupid nigga. Like, to where they can be like, I don't know why this nigga keep doing this, or I don't know why I stay with him and he got 6, 7, 8 girlfriends with a wife on the side. Hello.
Wow.
We back, because he got married when he was in jail. I'm just saying. You know? But that seems to be the person that they going for.
The nigga that represents the baby boy. Are you in the ocean? Because I need to pull you out of the ocean, man.
Okay. It's cool.
You know why you gonna pull me out of the ocean? Because I'm telling the truth.
Because
I'm telling the truth.
It's actually almost that time.
I'm telling the truth.
There's 1,000 Jodies out there.
It's time to go. It's time to go. Right.
I never even got to say what I need to say about.
So here's the deal.
We was talking about stripping.
It's time to go.
We was talking about stripping in the school.
It's time to go. We want to thank everybody.
Stripping in the school? Who's stripping in school?
We're talking about school.
U-Nation Radio.
What?
On Monday Night Love Session. RMC on.
Wait a minute. Time out, though.
No, she said stripping in the school. Who the hell is stripping in the school?
On Facebook.
U-Nation Radio.
Time out.
No.
Check us out.
Listen.
On Instagram. U-Nation Radio.
Sea balling. Thank you for coming. If
stripping
you have
in the school.
Any last?
You know what I was trying to say.
That
I
you
do,
would like to say.
I do.
Zip it.
I do have a last word, and it's the point I was gonna make earlier, and I'll make it real quick. I want to say, my guy E40 is like a uncle, he's like an OG to me, to a lot of people in the game. A lot of people don't know this. He make the most ratchet shit that's
yes,
out.
He do.
The bitch record with Too Short, there was an anthem, right?
Mm-hmm.
What a lot of people don't know, and I know personally, is he been married for like 28, 30 years. He has never, ever, ever cheated on his wife. He's proud of it, and he'll tell you that story in a heartbeat.
There is good men out there.
So I say that to say, don't get caught up in the smoke, right, in the mirrors. It's people out here that's making his music. But that's real solid people,
mm-hmm,
you know, that he go to church and the whole bit, you know what I mean? It's just, he's an entertainer and it's entertainment.
That's what he do. Mm-hmm.
That's what I want to leave out.
That's
there.
What he do. Just like strip and strip, that don't mean they're less of a human.
But I think that the big thing of what you said is basically knowing that this is entertainment. You get what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Like, over Christmas break, like me and my sister, we always make like crazy videos because it's just funny to do. So we make fun of like whatever the popular song is at the time. But for me, it's like, this is entertainment. Like, I'm not trying to do this. You know
mm-hmm.
what I'm saying?
Right,
this
right.
is not the lifestyle that I'm living, but it's just so funny to do at the time. So I get why people want to, you know, sing, dance, rap, produce, do all that stuff, because there's a moment in time when it is fun, but when it becomes your reality or your world and that's what you're living,
right,
that's kind of where those lines
get
blurred and tricky.
Yeah.
But just knowing that there's a difference, this is entertainment, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, I didn't know that about E-40, and that's awesome. You know, even
I didn't
the man
either.
That,
I know,
you know what I mean? Because I would say, well, I don't know so much about Master P's married life, but I know one of the things when I used to work with him and his son, he wasn't letting Romeo do a whole lot of stuff. Like,
mm-hmm.
there was a Playboy mansion party. Master P was like, no, my son
right.
is not going to that. He needs to do his homework. He
yeah.
needs to do his
They're
work.
Regular
so,
parents. They're regular
you get what
people.
I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
I totally agree with that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
No, Saj, last words. And.
Oh, man,
we
got to call my mic.
Where's your mic at?
Last words on the topic or just in general?
Just in general.
Oh, yeah. Thanks for having me again. Happy New Year, everybody. It's been a pleasure each and every time. You can check my mixes out. They're free on my website, djnosage.com, Twitter, Instagram, all at NosageDJ. I'm headed to Zen Lounge after this, turning up with the bros for J5. Yo, yo to the Kappas.
What's going on up there, man? We might go up there.
Oh, shit, swing through. Kappa Alpha Psi, we having our Founders Day party over there.
So, okay, yeah, that's dope.
Yeah, definitely come through. January 15th, I'm DJing over at the W Hotel in Hollywood.
Okay.
15th?
January 15th.
Mm.
In there. It's free.
You're up.
Yeah.
That's all you got to say.
Yep.
Okay. You're not.
Yeah, so, big things coming in 2015. You know, working with Kevin McCall, being
hey,
his
Mac,
DJ.
Hey, Mac, Y-City. Whoop.
Yeah. And, I was DJing at Supper Club last Thursday. And I opened up for DJ Charisma, another DJ. So, you know, it's, major things to come. So, you know, I'm blessed, I'm humbled. And at the same time, you know, I'm grinding and, you know, I'm pushing through.
Just always remember us. Okay?
Hey,
as you.
That's why I'm here right now.
I know.
That's
I,
right.
I think he remembers
that's,
he's here.
No, I know.
My man.
That's DJ No Suds.
Hey, don't get take all that action out your neck.
DJ Ree.
Again, just want to say Happy New Year to everybody. Make sure you like us on all of our social medias, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, Google Plus. And I think we should end with Miss Akilah Trenae's little lifestyle video.
Just know I don't condone this. I don't condone this, but I'm telling you, I didn't condone this, so I'm just.
I can't believe she allowed them to do this to me.
No, I'm saying I didn't want them
to show it.
This was okay.
Oh, hey, show that shit because it's funny.
It's not. They crazy. I just want y'all to know.
Moms was in the joint.
I know, but y'all should have seen the one last year. Last year was funnier than this year.
Yo, turn it up.
Oh, you talking about our cypher?
Yes.
That's
cypher was funny.
I had to step back for a minute because my stomach was hurting from the last.
Moms was like, hey.
I thought you was already
playing it.
Yeah. Good night.
Good night.
Hey. My last child.
Red homie, thugger. Red homie, thugger.
Rich gang.
About to play beat.
Got like.
Just live this here lifestyle. Can't straight from the bottom to the top. My lifestyle.
Living life like a beginning. This is only beginning. I'm on the top of the mountain, puffing on clouds. Still beginning. Big five on the Visa card. 100 bands. I won't do nothing with the can't even get me hot. Something wrong with the even though I ain't gonna hit it, I'ma still make sure that she. Cause when me and my brother don't get caught up like that, no way.
No way.
We ain't got time to go see doctors. Jay,
woo,
hey.
Good morning.
I put my paper up on the yarn and why? Hey, this is show for I do this for my daughters and all my sons. Woo. I run a random bands up, take out their funds.
Are you in?
I got a Muslim.
What?
She got a Muslim. Sisters and brothers to feed. I ain't gone, not like no idiot. I'm a OG.
I done did a lot. Just live this here lifestyle. Now came straight from the bottom to the top. My lifestyle.
Living like a beginning. This is only beginning. I'm on the top of the mountain, puffing on cloud. Still beginning. Still streaming to the other side. I'm a ride for my, hey.
Convoy.
I'm a tie for my, hey.
Convoy.
I ain't gonna feel nothing on my Monday.
No way, no way.
Couldn't see me if they had a genie.
Woo.
I'm living my life like Beanie. R.I.P. my brother Beanie.
R.I.P.
I stacked them right to the ceiling. Now these can't beat me.
Right.
I just might wake up when Chanel and these can't see me.
Woo.
I'm in a whole nother league.
Risk. I ain't got AIDS, but I swear to God I'm a bleed.
Woo. Till I D.I.E. 28 flows up, I feel like I can F.L.Y.E. Top, top, put it.
Just live this here lifestyle. Came straight from the bottom to the top. My lifestyle.
Living life like a beginning. This is only beginning. I'm on the top of the mountain, puffing on clouds. Still beginning.
I do it for my daddy. I do it for my mama. Them long nights, I swear to God, I do it for the
come.
I'm willing to be on my chest in the jungle.
Hey.
Money, home, money, I got commas and I ain't paid.
Nah.
Shining through my day, I been grinding with no shit.
Swap.
I'm talking about taking something from me like no weed.
Nah.
Tuggle, tuggle, that my brother, brother.
Tuggle.
You don't want no trouble, trouble.
Or
you can't get these fists, knuckle, knuckle.
Hey.
Buckle up like a seatbelt or I shoot ya. Punching on the gas, too fast, and I lose ya.
Hey.
Give me a bed, and I do her.
Hey.
I want a Medusa.
Ooh.
I swear, don't cut it strong, I'm blowing super.
Hey.
Hey. Grinding for a new day. I'm scared. Like that new blue face. Hey, I'm on the top, just like Toupe. Weed, I'm in her mouth, just like Toupe.
Did a lot. Just live this here lifestyle.
Yeah.
Can't escape from the bottom to the top of my lifestyle.